What is up, all my favorite people of the whole entire world? What is up with you guys? Today I am reviewing You Were Really Never There. Now, this film is one of those indie films. I've been looking forward to this. I never saw a trailer going to it. I really just saw the poster, and I knew Joaquin Phoenix was in it. And Joaquin Phoenix is a big pro, because I think this guy is one of the most underappreciated actors in Hollywood working today. Because when the guy takes on a role, he delves into the role. Because the thing about him is that when he pops up on the screen, I'm like, oh, there's Joaquin Phoenix. But the thing about the guy is when he's on screen, he just goes into the role where, at the point where, even though you recognize him, it's more of like, I know this guy, as a deja vu thing, but this guy is, like, acting. And you do not recognize him at all. And that's something that's great about this film, is that his performance holds this film up to a totally different level. He is so great as the character of Joe in this film, who, Joe is this, not a bad guy, but he's this kind of, like, anti-hero of some sense, who he kills people, and he saves people, but he does it for his own reasoning. But that's the reasoning where, I guess, if I'm going to get into this before I really get into any of my pros, I'm going to start with my negatives in a weird sense. And one of my weird negatives is I wanted more of Joe's back history, because we do get small little flashbacks of him, and some of it makes sense, but there's other things that I'm trying to piece together, and I'm like, okay, like, I think I know what it meant, but I think it didn't. And that's the thing about this film. This is a very artsy indie film that some people are gonna really hate, and some people are gonna think really boring, and then some people are gonna love this film. Where do I fall into those categories? I actually find myself just liking and thinking the film's a very well-made film. I don't love this film yet, and I don't hate it at all. Like, I just walked out and I was very conflicted. I mean, I had to sleep on this film because I really had to think, did I love it or did I hate it? And you know, I'm still in just, it was a good film. I enjoyed it, and I would totally recommend it. Like I said, a lot of that has to go with Joaquin Phoenix's performance, because his performance is fantastic in here. He just embodied this role of this just guy. What I said about this film, though, after I walked out, is I said this is kind of like a more artistic version of Brawl and Cell Block 99, which I loved Brawl. I know some people didn't, but I love the film to death. But I felt like Brawl was more like a straightforward, like, this is the story, this is the characters, this is who you're dealing with. This film goes for more of that artsy feeling, especially with the action scenes, because when it gets to the action scenes, I was like, alright, let's kick some ass, and some of the action is filmed very well in here, like, very well, up and close, personal, like, gritty sense of to that manner, but then some of it did not. It's filmed in a very more artsy way, and a more stylized way, which, when you see the film, maybe you'll think differently, but I wish it would have been more up and close and personal, more gritty to that thing, because the aesthetics for this film are very gritty. The look of this film feels very gritty and grim, and I like the aesthetics, the feel, and the vibe that I got. Even from the second this film started, I was already digging the aesthetics, and the whole entire film carries that throughout. But I wish the action scenes would have taken more of that aesthetic and gone with it, and not gone for like, oh, look how cool this is, and this is how I'm going to film this action scene, I'm going to use a camera in a hallway to show you how he's killing these people. I'm like, no, I want up close and personal. I think that would have been a very much more agile way to make me feel more into Joe's body. And I think that's the thing, because I felt like a lot of this film was from Joe's perspective, and I think that would have added more to Joe's perspective. Overall, I liked this movie. I find it enjoyable. It's certainly a good watch, and I do recommend it just to see what it is and how it is, because it's a very intriguing character study of some sense with the character of Joe, and it has some really cool moments in it as well, and it's a surprising film. There's some stuff that happens in here where your jaw just drops all of a sudden, because it's shocking. There's a lot of good twists and turns in here. I wish the story would have been a little bit more straightforward, with some of the action also being a little bit more up close and personal, but with a heavy-handed performance, probably the best performance I've seen this year, to be honest, and just a fantastic score. The score and the sound mixing and all the soundtracks are great. The aesthetics really kick you into the vibe of this film. I enjoyed this film, and I hope you guys go and check it out. It's called You Were Really Never There. It's another indie film, and if you're in the Phoenix area, it's actually opening up on April 13th, so I hope you guys go and check that out. Make sure to look at other theaters if you're in other states. Make sure to see what's going on in those markets. But of course, guys, with all that said, I'm going to give You Were Really Never There a B-. looking forward to whatever else this director does do, because I like this aesthetics and the vibe that he got to it, and it felt like his own directing style. It didn't seem like any other director's style that I'd seen that he was trying to copy, and I like that. Tell me, guys, have you heard about this film? Are you excited for it? Are you not? Do you know what this film's about? I'm curious to hear your guys' thoughts down below, so make sure to go hit me up down below. Make sure to comment and tell me what you guys thought of You Were Really Never There. Also, if you guys are more interested in talking movies, make sure to hit up all my social media links, Twitter, Stardust, and Instagram. That's where I leave a lot of my first reactions for my films, mostly Twitter and Stardust though. And also, make sure to go hit that like and subscribe button so you guys never miss a video, and it shows me that you guys really enjoyed this video. And the most important thing you guys gotta remember to do though is hit up Sandwich on Films, the website I'm a part of, where you guys can win advanced screening tickets, check out some movie news, and also other movie reviews. That's gonna be an awesome time, guys. Of course, you guys are all the best. Do not forget that. And until next time, stay classy.